A plane created purely to spite Nazi Germany that sadly missed its chance. Today, I will be explaining the misfortunate history of the often forgotten Bugatti 100P and some of the fateful events that surround it. Ettore Bugatti was born in Milan, Italy, on the 15th of September, 1881. In 1909, he founded his own automobile company in Molsheim in the Alsace region. The Alsace region was controlled by the German Empire until 1919. When control returned to France, the Bugatti race cars were incredibly successful in the 1920s and 30s, collectively winning over 2,000 races. During that time period, Bugatti enjoyed seeing the small machines that bore his name defeat the larger and more powerful machines of his major rivals, the German vehicles from Mercedes-Benz and Auto Union. In 1936, Bugatti began to consider the possibility of building an aircraft around two straight, eight-cylinder Bugatti Type 50B engines, very similar to the engines that powered the Bugatti Grand Prix race cars. This aircraft would be used to make attempts on several speed records. Most importantly, the 3-kilometer world landplane speed record, then held by Howard Hughes in the Hughes H1 racer at 567.115 kilometers per hour. Bugatti turned to Louis de Monge, a Belgian engineer, to help design the aircraft known as the Bugatti Model 100. Before construction of the Bugatti 100P began, Germany demonstrated what it felt was its aerial superiority by setting a new 3-kilometer world landplane speed record at 610.95 kilometers per hour in a Messerschmitt Bf 109 on the 11th of November 1937. Bugatti disliked Nazi Germany and was very interested in beating their record. Bugatti and de Monge continued to develop the 100P for an attempt to capture the 3-kilometer record from Germany. The Bugatti 100P was one of the sleekest aircraft ever built, with the exception of engine exhaust ports. The 7.75-meter fuselage was completely smooth. The aircraft employed wood monocoque sandwich construction, in which layers of balsa wood were glued and carved to achieve the desired aerodynamic shape. Hardwood rails and supports were set into the balsa wood to take concentrated loads of stress points. The airframe was then covered with tulip wood strips, which were then sanded and filed. Finally, the aircraft was covered with linen and doped. The Bugatti 100P stood 2.23 meters tall and weighed 1,400 kilograms.
The 100P had an 8.235-meter one-piece wing that was slightly forward-swept with a single box spar that ran through the fuselage. The wing was constructed in the same fashion as the fuselage and housed the fully retractable and enclosed main gear. The wing featured a multi-purpose, self-adjusting flap system. Both the upper and lower flap surfaces automatically moved up or down to suit the speed of the aircraft and the power setting of the engines. For example, at high manifold pressure and very low airspeed, the flaps set themselves to takeoff position. At low airspeed and low power, the flaps dropped into landing position and the landing gear was automatically lowered. In a dive, the flaps pivoted apart to form air brakes. The Bugatti's tail surfaces consisted of two butterfly units and a ventral fin at 120-degree angles. They were constructed with the same wood sandwich method used on the fuselage and wing. Also, the tip of the ventral fin incorporated a retractable tail skid to assist in landing. For cooling, air was scooped into ducts in the leading edges of the butterfly tail and ventral fin. The air was turned 180 degrees, flowed into a plenum chamber in the aft fuselage, and passed through a two-section radiator, one section for each engine. The now heated air again turned 180 degrees and exited out the fuselage sides into a low pressure area behind the trailing edge of the wings. The high pressure at the intake and low pressure at the outlet created natural air circulation that required no fans or blowers. The two Bugatti T50B straight 8-cylinder engines were specifically made for the 100P aircraft. The engine crankcases were made of magnesium to reduce weight, and each engine used a lightweight, Roots-type supercharger, feeding two downdraft carburetors. The standard T50B race car engine produced 480 horsepower at 5,000 RPM. An output of 450 horsepower at 4,500 RPM is usually given for the 100P's engines. However, de Monge stated the engines planned for the 100P were to produce 550 horsepower each. The engines were situated in tandem. Behind the pilot, the front engine was canted to the right, and drove a drive shaft that passed by the pilot's right side. The rear engine was canted to the left and drove a drive shaft that passed by the pilot's left side. The two shafts joined into a common reduction gearbox just beyond the pilot's feet. The gearbox allowed each engine to drive a metal, two-blade ground-adjusted ratio propeller. Together, the two propeller sets made a coaxial contra-rotating unit. From the gearbox, the rear propeller shaft, driven by the front engine, was hollow, and the front shaft, driven by the rear engine, rotated inside of it. Once the new design was finalized in 1938, Construction of the 100P was begun at a high-quality furniture factory in Paris. While construction proceeded, it was obvious that the war would break out soon. France did not have any fighters that could match the performance of their German counterparts. The French Air Ministry felt that the 100P could be developed into a light pursuit or reconnaissance fighter and awarded the contract to Bugatti in 1939. This fighter was to be equipped with at least one gun mounted in each wing, an oxygen system, and self-sealing fuel tanks. Most aspects of the fighter are unknown, but it is possible that it was larger than the 100P and incorporated 525 horsepower T-50B engines installed side-by-side in the fuselage, driving six-blade coaxial contra-rotating propellers with a 37mm cannon firing through the propeller hub. Because of France's surrender, the aircraft never progressed beyond the initial design phase. Bugatti's contract included a bonus of 1 million francs if the 100P racer captured the world speed record, which the Germans had raised to 746.606 kilometers per hour with a Heinkel HE-100 on the 30th of March 1939, and raised again to 755.138 kilometers per hour with a Messerschmitt ME-209 on the 26th of April the same year. Bugatti and Demange felt the 100P was capable of around 800 kilometers per hour. In addition, a smaller version of the racer, known as the 110P, was planned. It featured a 1.5-meter reduced wingspan of 6.7 meters. The 110P was to have the same engines as the 100P, and the top speed was estimated at 885 kilometers per hour. However, other sources indicate these figures were very optimistic, and the expected performance was more around 640 kilometers per hour for the 100P and 768 kilometers per hour for the 110P. The 100P was nearly complete when Germany invaded France. As the Germans closed in on Paris in June 1940, the Bugatti 100P and miscellaneous parts, presumably for the 110P, were removed from the furniture factory and loaded on a truck. The 100P was taken out into the country and hidden in a barn on Bugatti's Emerinville Castle estate, 50 kilometers northeast of Paris. Ettore Bugatti died on the 21st of August, 1947. With the 100P still stashed away in Emerinville. The aircraft was purchased by M. Serge Pozzoli in 1960, but remained in Emerinville until 1970, when it was sold to Ray Jones, an expert Bugatti automobile restorer from the United States. Both Pozzoli and Jones offered the 100P to French museums, but were turned down. Jones acquired the 100P with the intent to complete the aircraft, however, the goal could not be completed due to missing parts. Jones had the two Bugatti Type 50B engines removed from the airframe before everything was shipped to the United States. Dr. Peter Williamson purchased the airframe and moved it to Vintage Auto Restorations in Ridgefield, Connecticut in February 1971 to begin a lengthy restoration. Lou Demange was now living in the United States and assisted with some aspects of the restoration work before he passed away in 1977. In 1979, the unfinished 100P was donated to the Air Force Museum Foundation with the hope of having the restoration completed and the aircraft loaned to a museum for display. However, the aircraft sat until 1996 when it was donated to the Experimental Aircraft Association, EAA, in Oshkosh, Wisconsin, and finally underwent a full restoration. The restored but engineless Bugatti 100P is currently on display at the EAA Air Venture Museum. The original engines out of the Model 100P were reportedly not the final version of the engines intended for the actual speed record run. Both engines still exist and are installed in Bugatti automobiles. The front engine is installed in Ray Jones's 1937 Type 59/50B Grand Prix Racer, and the rear engine is installed in Charles Dean's 1935 Type 59/50B Grand Prix Racer. Starting in January 2009, Scotty Wilson led an international team, including Louis Demange's grandnephew, Ladislaw Demange, to build a flying replica of the Bugatti 100P in Tulsa, Oklahoma. Piloted by Wilson, the Bugatti 100P replica flew for the first time on the 19th of August, 2015. Tragically, Scotty Wilson was killed when the replica crashed during a test flight on the 6th of August, 2016. What do you think of the Bugatti 100P? Do you think it would have been an effective fighter, or was it better off being hidden throughout the war? Let me know in the comments. And while you are down there, don't forget to hit subscribe and maybe like the video as well. Anyways, thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed. If you would like, you can click on one of the videos or playlists above to check out more of my content. Thanks again for watching, and I hope you enjoy the rest of your day.